Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. On today's Everything Music, I'm going to teach you how to read any rhythm. What we're going to need to do is we're going to memorize six different rhythms that I call sight rhythms. There are two elements to rhythm reading. One is notes and the other are rests. We're going to start with notes first. I'm going to use 16th notes to demonstrate these six patterns, but we could easily use eighth notes or quarter notes. I'll show you that as well. The first pattern you're going to memorize is 4 16th notes. We're going to subdivide it like most people do, which is the beat number 1, E, and The E is the second 16th note, the and is the third 16th note, and the is the fourth 16th note. So it'll go 1, E, and 2, E, and 3, E, and 4, E, and Here's pattern 1. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, E, and 2, E, and 3, E, and 4, E, and
I just want to go over something real quickly. When we're counting this out, the 1, E, and the plus sounds like and. That's how people typically say it. So 1, E, and 2, E, and Here are eighth notes represented. So if you were to count eighth notes, you'd go 1, and 2, and. So those ands line up with these ands. Here's pattern 2. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, and 2, and 3.
Here's pattern 3. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, E, and 2, E, and 3, E, and 4, E, and.
Here's pattern 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, E, 2, E, 3, E, 4, E,
Anytime you have a fourth 16th note in a grouping, it always belongs to the next set of 16ths, okay? So it'd be 1, E, and 2, 2. So you want to make these. This is going to belong to the next one. This is going to belong to 3, okay? So you always want to think about da-da, da-da-da, da-da-da. So remember, da-da, da-da-da, 2, 3, 4, da-da, da-da-da, da-da-da. So it's a pickup to the next grouping. Here's pattern 5. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4,
And the last pattern, number 6, goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1 E, 2 E, 3 E, 4 E.
Next, I'd like to talk about equivalent rhythms. All of these rhythms sound the same if you look at the BPMs. This rhythm at 50 BPMs sounds identical to this rhythm at 100 BPMs, and it sounds identical to this rhythm at 200 BPMs. So all you need to do is know how to read these patterns and know that they are rhythmic equivalents. So this pattern, 3 and 4. This top rhythm is the same if I go 1, 2, 3, 4. That would be the same in eighths and quarters. And the same thing here if I did twice the rhythm, which is really too fast to clap. Okay, so let's talk about rests next. Now with rest, many of these patterns sound identical to the other ones, just the 16th note is shorter. For example, this pattern, this first pattern, da 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 da, 1 E and, 1 E and, okay? It sounds like this, it would be a short eighth note, which you could write it either way. And you'll see rhythms written this way many, many times, where you could have an eighth note with a dot on it and it would be the same thing. This, however, is a unique rhythm. That's why I have this star here. Rest, da, 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 rest, da, 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 rest, da, 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 rest, e, and, e, and, e, and, e, and, e, and, e, and. Number 3 would simply be det, 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 det. It sounds like two short eighth notes, but it's really 16ths. So it's 1, e, and. So 1 and then and. So det, 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 det. They're just short. So if you wanted somebody to play, articulate it short, if you're playing a trumpet part, for example, this rhythm you would see played commonly. Now, I wrote it this way with a beam because it's more of a modern way to write it instead of writing a 16th note, 16th rest, another 16th note, another 16th note rest. Typically, you would see that in orchestral writing. You'll see this as a shortcut. This is a unique rhythm. So it'd be 1, E, and, 1, E, and, 3, 4, Number 5, you could have written as an eighth note with a dot on it, so it's short. But it'd be like 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 E and, that and, that, that, that. So that's not unique. Number 6 here is unique. Rest up, rest up. So 1 E and, 1 E and, 1 E and. Number 7, Since the 16th note lies on a beat, it's not unique because it comes on and. Number eight is a unique rhythm because we have a 16th note on the last, so it would be one E and a, three, four, one E and a, one E and a, one E and a, one E and a, okay? Number nine and number 10 sound identical, actually. If you went, now this is an eighth note, rest, 16th note, and this is 16th, rest, rest, 16th. But you could say it's da, 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 da. This would be da, da, da. This would be that, 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 that. All you need to do is memorize these 10 patterns with the rests. Combine them with the six patterns from before, and you have all the possible combinations of four 16th notes. Or if you make them eighth notes, it's the same thing. Change everything here to eighth notes, and then you know how to perform these same rhythms as eighth notes. Okay, the last thing we're going to talk about are triplets. Now, I did the same thing with these triplet equivalents. Triplet 16th notes at 50 BPMs are going to sound the same as eighth note triplets at 100 BPM, which are going to sound the same as quarter note triplets at 200 BPMs. But in reality, the way that these would work is this. If we put these all against a quarter note, the triplet 16th would sound like this. The eighth note triplet would sound like this. Three, four. With the downbeats on both of those falling on strong beats. But with the quarter note triplets, it's a little bit different. You get this three against two feel or hemiola, which would be this, a pattern like this. Three, four. Ba, 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 ba. So every half note, you fall on a downbeat. Three, four. Ba, 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 ba. That's a three against two pattern or a hemiola. Any of you that watch any of my jazz videos will know that we use triplets a lot on the second beat in bebop because that's kind of a Charlie Parker thing or really a bebop thing. Rest, ba, da, 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 do, da, boo, ba. Okay, now this is a tied note, but really it's playing da 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 da. Okay, in jazz we play swing eighth notes. See, these eighths are played as triplets with a triplet feel. It's called a swing feel. These are called swing eighths. So three, four, ba do ba 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 da do da do da. Okay, let's take a look at a real-world example. This is John Williams' Superman theme. Let's take a look at this rhythm. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. And if you're interested in the Beato book, you can write me at rickbeato1@gmail.com. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification button. Thanks for watching. I'm Rick Beato.